My name is Tony Gabrielli Phelan. I am with Undergraduate Career Services here at Daniels. Thank you all for coming and doing your DPDP requirements and staying on top of it. And feel free to make appointments with us, come chat with us if you ever want to talk about anything related to your career search, even if that's picking a major. So I'm going to let these guys give their own introductions. So here you go, take it away.
Sure.
Hi, guys.
Professor Greg Wagner.
I'm also the internship director,
and we'll get to that.
Is a part of this.
Whole marketing presentation because
internships,
you're going to hear from me over and over. So important.
But my background, 30 years in advertising.
Worked at a big ad agency called Darcy McManus Benton Bowles.
I was a creative director there.
Then I finished my career at Leo Burnett in Detroit.
Anybody ever hear of Leo Burnett?
Anybody heard of Detroit?
There's a Detroit right there.
You've heard of Leo Burnett?
Good.
Leo Burnett is one of the probably oldest, biggest ad agencies in the U.S.
And they're headquartered in Chicago. So anyway, long story short, I got into teaching.
Kind of by accident.
My alma mater, University of Missouri School of Journalism, asked me to come back and guest lecture.
And I did.
And I had a lot of fun doing it.
And then they offered me a job at Mizzou. Anybody ever hear of Mizzou?
All right.
Go Tigers.
Anyway, I ended up doing some workshops there.
And from there, I thought this is pretty cool.
I like giving back and teaching what I learned out there in the big bad world.
And so it was kind of a nice transition to teaching advertising.
Which I teach.
We have four advertising classes. We'll get to that too.
But I ended up a little bit for a while teaching at Boulder CU.
Good journalism school up there, taught copywriting, taught portfolio.
And then I ended up guest lecturing down here 12 years ago.
And somebody said, hey, would you like to work here full time?
So I've been here 10, 12 years teaching and doing the internships.
So that's kind of me in a nutshell.
Take it away, Michael.
So I've been in the digital marketing realm for about 17 years.
Consulting for the last 10, and have been teaching here since 2010.
So teach everything from mobile, social search, and work with small clients now. Trying to help those build their business for startups, companies.
Large companies making it on plane, spend lots of time with families.
Interesting. So I've been here since 2010. Hope today's session is pretty open, conversational. I don't really feel like I can definitely talk nonstop, but I don't want that necessarily. So stop us and interrupt us along the way.
If you have questions,
and we'll get started.
Any questions before we begin? No? Cool.
So we're here today to talk about the marketing major. The marketing major has five core classes. Consumer behavior is the first one.
Trying to figure out how consumers purchase things and how they make those decisions towards purchasing additional products.
Business, obviously, what it sounds like when you are selling products or services to other businesses. We walk you through how that model works.
Marketing research is exactly what it sounds like, performing research for and with various clients to become a better business.
International marketing.
So what does marketing look like from an international standpoint, various countries, various cultures, and various standards.
And integrated marketing strategy simply means that you need to look at marketing from a holistic view instead of just social media, it's not just email marketing.
What is the entire palette of ways that you can go ahead and market to individuals?
And so there are four marketing electives on top of this.
The popular electives, of course, Greg and I do.
That's why I listed all these out.
So I teach all the digital classes. With the exception of some foundations in digital marketing.
So we cover how to use Facebook advertising, how to do email marketing, and how to map out user experience.
What that means is user experience from the time that you interact with the business for the first time to the time that you actually write a check or give your credit card.
How does that experience map out, and how does that map out beyond
Post-purchase.
Social media marketing.
I have to tell you what social media marketing is.
You may not be
the right group.
It means utilizing things like Snapchat to help kind of build your business and the brand of the business.
Make money as well.
Mobile marketing. Obviously,
you'll have cell phones and some of them right now.
But just in case.
So figuring out how to use mobile technology and mobile behavior to help build businesses.
Pretty interesting class.
Tech and marketing.
We get as technical as you can stand getting technical.
So we teach Photoshop,
Adobe Illustrator,
HTML, and CSS.
The focus of that class is pretty simple. It's focused on tools.
But the goal is
to give you some skills that you can leave with and go get shiny jobs and
make good money.
It's
awesome.
Search engine marketing.
So how do you utilize Google to help build your business and build awareness for your business?
We talk about that
in this upcoming quarter in spring.
We're going to have a client.
How many know who DaVita is?
So pretty large company,
they're going to be the primary client for that class.
I'm pretty excited.
They have some big scaling issues.
Data science for marketers.
Unless you've been under a large rock,
data science is kind of where the future is
in regards to all businesses.
So we blend that into kind of marketing techniques
and we'll help you figure out how best to utilize those skills for your
companies that you're working for.
And do they still call that big data?
Is there a new buzzword?
No, I'll say this.
If you want to get slapped by a CMO,
say big data.
They've heard it so much for the last five years, they're kind of tired of it.
So just say we can use data to do this and you'll be okay.
That's a great question.
Okay, and then Greg teaches the advertising class.
Yeah, quickly intro to advertising.
Just the big picture of what an ad agency does.
All the departments.
What's cool about advertising is it's really about seven or eight companies in one.
We need research people.
That are now called strategic planners.
We need creative people, copywriters, art directors, producers.
We need media people that think in numbers and data.
We need PR.
It's really cool.
That's what's neat about an ad agency.
It's about 10 companies, digital is huge now
in the ad world.
There's always a digital department.
So when you work for an ad agency,
in my case, I was in the outdoor department, media department,
I was in account service, and ended up in creative.
So it's very dynamic.
So you learn an intro, teach all about
What happens in ad creative?
My favorite background.
I bring in real clients.
We work on Nike.
We work on McDonald's.
We work on Vail Resorts.
I bring in real clients who do real work.
You do an ad campaign for a real client.
They brief you.
And that's your final exam.
In the case of ad strategy, that's all we do.
No tests. You get four projects, four things for your portfolio.
You know, when you go out to get a job, you say, I worked on McDonald's.
I worked on BMW.
Okay.
I like working on big brands.
Media strategy is all about the media world. Michael knows now it's just exploded.
It's like digital.
Media used to just be a department in the ad agency.
Now they have their own media companies.
Leo Burnett has two huge media companies.
Starcom, Media Best, Chicago, New York.
So media is huge.
Account management. This is a cool class. I co-teach it.
With Gary Barant, who started the first ad agency in Russia.
This guy's brilliant, witty, funny, global.
Gary is on the account side, he's a creative.
So we work together.
And we bring in real clients.
This year we did the Chevy Bolt.
We were with the ad agency.
Actually working on the original pitch.
So that was cool.
So that's what I do. We have four classes, all electives.
But you also learn how to be a brand manager.
Anybody know what a brand manager is?
Take a rough guess.
A brand manager.
Bueller.
Bueller.
Brand managers are the guys on the client side.
Procter and Gamble.
Procter and Gamble.
Gatorade.
Waker Oats.
Waker Oats.
On the client side. You're not going to end up on the ad agency side or digital.
You'll end up as a brand manager.
You're responsible for Budweiser. It's a big job. And you're constantly working with the ad agency.
Because you're the one that's approving the work.
Okay.
So it's a really,
big responsibility.
Huge.
A lot of you guys, I think,
even if you don't go into marketing,
if you go into management or finance,
you could end up in one of the big corporate companies.
On the account side or on the brand management side.
Okay.
You want to talk about personal selling?
Sure.
Personal selling is something Michelle teaches.
We'll talk about that in a minute.
She teaches you basically how to solve problems. So it sounds like a sales class, but sales are part of solving problems.
The thing I should mention, I forgot to mention,
digital classes, just like Greg's, have real world clients.
And it's not like my friends for the last 10 years come to the same project.
We go get new clients every single quarter.
And again, you actually get to work on that. So one of the biggest problems that you find when you get out of here, you don't have any practical experience.
A lot of times you are able, taking my classes or Greg's classes, to be able to say,
I did this part of the document, another person, so we actually did the work for the client.
And if the client chooses to move on and do that work, absolutely get you set up with an internship as well.
So it's definitely real world.
Greg and I are probably talking about at least academics here.
I do not have a PhD.
I can spell PhD.
Greg does not have a PhD.
And he can spell PhD.
So just a lot of different opportunities as far as real world business experience.
And again, marketing is all about generating profit.
We also teach a class called sports marketing.
His name is Brian Kitts. He actually runs Red Rocks
and some other venues.
And he teaches a class on sports marketing.
Pretty cool class.
Really popular.
Yes, very popular.
And then product innovation. I teach that to seniors.
To grad students and undergrads.
So we work with you to come up with innovative ideas based on the latest technologies,
stem cell, artificial intelligence, those kinds of things.
So if you're a technical person, you like that field, marketing in a lot of ways is for you, from a product perspective.
I definitely wanted to put some faces to the people that are teaching you.
So this is Michelle Lutz. Personal selling. This is Dr. Bashara. Dr. Akaka.
Thank you very much.
Don Bacon, if you try to find a shirt that says everybody loves bacon, just to wear it.
Two new PhDs. We have Anna and Gia, thank you very much, and this guy you may recognize, so we have other people in our department.
We're a pretty active, fast moving department.
The chance of you being bored with one of our classes is very, very slim.
So skills that are developed in our classes.
Research changes to overall ecosystem technology, society, demographics.
So you will learn how to research and figure out what's going on within the business world.
Critical and creative thinking, obviously, problem solving, that's kind of all start, right?
Use of analytical skills. So we will be working with tools that are used in the real world.
That's another great way to go get a job.
If you're certified in Google Analytics or certified in Facebook Blueprint,
it's much easier to go get a job than saying, I'm really smart and I've got a piece of paper to prove it, right?
They want you to have some hard skills.
And then performance is part of a high-performing team.
Most of the stuff you've already probably experienced this far in your collegiate career.
Is group projects.
We do some individual projects, but most of it is group projects.
If you take me, the biggest team will be two people.
Nobody gets to hide in my class.
Awesome.
And then recognition of ethical and legal issues. So everything that we do, especially in product innovation, we talk about that kind of throughout the core of all the classes.
Is there any questions on what we talked about so far?
Don't be afraid.
You good?
Nice.
Yes, sir.
Because he's from Kroenke Entertainment, I think is his background.
And so he currently has a job running those things, and he's chosen to come in and give back.
And kind of add some expertise to our department.
Why doesn't he do like a music?
You can totally recommend that one.
See his eyes light up?
Yeah.
You could do that. We're trying to talk him into several other classes.
Pretty busy.
So we're trying to get him to at least teach one other class. So we'll see how that goes. But I think that'd be awesome.
We have adjunct professors who are, you know, have like this guy has a job.
He only comes here once or twice a week to teach.
So we have a nice mixture of full-time professors and adjuncts who,
head of a PR firm, head of an agency.
And I started as an adjunct as well.
Right.
So you should ask Brian Kitts.
Go see him. He'd be like, who are you?
Career paths that you can take.
This is pretty flexible. But
emotional strategy,
creatives, things like account managers,
digital agencies,
working for advertising agencies.
So there's some differences between those two as far as the skill set that's expected.
If you're in a digital agency, you need to have that digital expertise.
At least have mastered one or two tools
that they will utilize.
And then you can obviously, as Greg mentioned, go work in-house.
So agency life is pretty exciting when you first start, but it pretty quickly gets real scary. You're like, wow, I haven't been home in three days.
And I smell funky.
And I'd really like to go see my dog and stuff like that.
It's exciting when you first start.
But after a while, you're like, it'd be nice to just work on client side and boss people around in a nice way.
Product innovation with go-to-market strategies is definitely something you could be doing
for consumer goods firms, tech firms, and a host of others.
So in Denver, we have some very large companies that we do internships with, but we also can get you set up with really small companies
that you want to work for.
I personally, in my class, how many have heard of the robotics company Spiro?
What Spiro is?
No.
See the Star Wars movie with BB-8 rolls around?
The toy that came out.
It's actually a company called Spiro.
They're out of Boulder.
And you have people leaving Apple to Google to go work for those guys.
So one of my students said, I guessed him what his dream job was as far as his project, but I'd like to work for Spiro.
It's a pretty good job now.
Like to work for Spiro.
So we got him set up doing a project for Spiro.
So if you encourage anybody in the marketing department
to help you network to a company you want to do a project for
and or work for,
they will work with you on that.
Okay.
Very much more real. Less.
Pricing strategy for new established products and service pricing teams.
I always raise the price, so I'm not good at that.
Professional sales and sales management.
So again, selling is about solving problems. If you're going to solve problems, you need to be pretty smart about knowing what's going on out there.
Any questions? You'll always be selling, no matter what you do. If you're an accountant, you're a seller. You're presenting.
When you're looking for a job, you're selling yourself.
But you're going to be selling your whole life.
And that's one thing that I know Michael does too. I get you up on your feet presenting.
You're presenting all the time.
You got to be a great presenter.
In this world.
You got to be able to sell your work.
Whether it's the ad agency or the client side.
Wherever you are, you're going to always be selling your boss, his boss.
So you've got to be a good presenter.
So we really try to work with you guys on that.
That's why Michelle's class of selling is really good.
Because she has you up on your feet all the time.
Any questions?
No.
Okay. Okay.
I'm going to let Greg talk about the internship program that we have.
Okay. So number one is get on my mailing list.
I have a thing called the marketing email list.
And if you're a marketing major or minor,
you want to get on that list.
I'm posting four or five things a week.
I work closely with Bob in the career services because he's got a huge database too of things going on right now.
So I'm networking together. I send him my stuff, he sends me opportunities.
But if you're on the mailing list, you're seeing four or five internships a week.
Most of them are paid, by the way.
And we also post real jobs too.
We don't just post internships.
We post like Dish Network or Comcast or Greg, and two interns.
But they also need a beginner position starting at 40 grand.
So I'll send that to Bob, and I'll post it.
So we're always trying to help you guys
in the big picture.
Get a job, right? Isn't that what this is all about?
Getting a good job.
Okay, so you got to get on my mailing list.
Send me an email.
I get you on the list.
Don Bacon, who is our head research guy in marketing,
two years ago came up to me and said, Greg,
Guess what the number one thing on the resume is? I go, grade point? No, no, that's five.
Five? Five?
Yeah, everyone's got, everyone's got a 3-point something.
All right,
all right.
The number one,
the number one thing in the resume
with people that you're sending your resume to
is what internships have you had? Okay. Okay. Now most of the students
that I work
that
with,
I work with get two or three.
I have a couple of sophomores coming to me.
In fact, don't you have one? You have one with me right now? Hi.
Erica just got one.
Yeah.
And that is really being forward thinker.
Here, as a freshman,
she's already thinking about internships.
That's smart.
We built a database of 500 plus companies just here in Denver
that we work with.
Okay.
Okay.
Big companies like Dish, Coors,
and Integer, and Crispin Porter.
And then little startups.
They'll email me too.
Or some guy, a PhD doctor who's writing a book and he needs some help marketing his book.
And we check all these people out to make sure they're legit.
But you can get credit, four hours, whatever.
Depending on how many hours a week you work at the internship.
I'll give you credit.
You got to write a paper.
You get a letter from your boss.
That's it.
You come in, you sign up with me.
I don't see you until the end of the semester when you turn in your paper.
Okay.
We also have a scholarship with our internship called the Taylor Scholarship.
Andy Taylor, who's the CEO of Enterprise Rent-A-Car,
gave us a bunch of money.
Thank you, Andy. And we love to give out scholarship money.
So you get a paid internship.
And get the Taylor Scholarship.
And credit.
So three ways to win.
Like I said, it looks good when you have a couple of three internships on your resume.
Yes, it says your employer.
Wow.
She worked at an ad agency.
She worked on the corporate side.
And she helped us start digital.
By the way, digital, very hot. Almost four out of five internships I post.
Want some digital experience.
So guys, even if you don't become a marketing major,
maybe you become a marketing minor.
And we have a ton.
In fact, I think Daniels,
we're number one, if I'm not mistaken.
In minors?
We are number one.
So we're number two in majors.
And I think we're number one in minors.
So on that mailing list, when an employer says, Greg, I need a couple of really good interns.
Guess what?
I reach over 500 kids with my mailings.
You're gonna get like 10 or 20 responses.
Okay, especially if it's paid.
It's in our marketing department.
Karen and I kind of run it.
If they want to get signed up, email me.
But they have to be, technically, you got to either be a marketing major or minor.
To get on my list.
I think they are a little sticky about you guys getting on my mailing list unless you're.
Now, if you're taking some of my ad classes and you're a psych major or a social major, and you're saying, hey, can I get on?
I'm like, yeah, all right, I'll get you on.
But I'm not supposed to have any of the job.
My boss, Carol Johnson, who you guys should meet.
She's department chair of marketing.
Carol and I kind of worked on this together.
She hired me to do this about eight years ago.
We had nobody in our database.
I take it back.
We had the Pepsi Center.
That was it.
And we're averaging about five interns a semester.
Right now, I'm at 35.
So a lot of you guys will end up being my interns.
Okay.
Like Eric.
She's already on the list.
So she's one this semester, I have 35 interns.
I also do the grad students.
So I have marketing grad students,
which is We only have 30 grad students maybe in marketing
right now.
And we've got,
I don't know how many majors in marketing,
but we got a lot.
Two to 50.
Yeah. And then all those minors.
Yeah.
So anyway,
that's kind of my spiel.
Any questions about internships?
Greg.
Besides, you gotta have them. What?
Down or next?
Sure.
Next.
Here's some of the companies, right? Where?
I'm watching.
Hey, man. He's the tech guy.
All right.
You're just some examples of who we work with.
Big and small.
National City Media.
They're a national company.
You're in the movie business.
You guys all know that one.
know that one better.
Great ad agency.
One of the most creative ad agencies in America.
Up in Boulder.
Karsh Hagen.
A lot of business.
Kathy Hagen.
We have a marketing board, by the way. This is pretty cool.
We have 10 to 12 professionals
who don't teach here except for Harry Brandt does.
But most of these people volunteer their time to help you guys if you're a marketing major with us.
And Kathy Hagen, who's part of Karsh Hagen Advertising,
is on our board.
Dish, we do a lot of work with them.
Nestle Purina.
We started networking with St. Louis.
One of my best friends is president of what's called
Checkmark Advertising.
In-house shop for Nestle.
Luke and I started to network.
Which is the key word, by the way, guys.
Network.
That's how you get a job.
I mean, that's really how you get a job.
You get to know people like me and Michael who will vouch for you.
You get to know friends of your family.
You know people who know people.
That's so key.
To get your foot in the door.
This is fun.
We got a bunch of industry interns there now.
They love it.
Stand up.
Okay.
Arrow's huge.
Made is a cool little digital company.
Scott.
Prindle.
He's the CEO.
Right. Chief Tech Officer.
This guy's brilliant.
He's also on our board.
I had him in my class.
Last week, my students were just like,
Oh my God.
I had him in my media class.
And my creative class.
And I'm taking notes.
Oh my God.
Is that really what's going on?
But I try and bring in guest speakers who know exactly what's going on right now.
I've been out of the agency business for 10 years.
Okay.
Who are those guys?
Cactus.
I didn't know that was a real cool creative shop.
Yeah.
You guys know them.
We do sports internships.
I've worked with the Rockies.
Worked with the Broncos.
And we've worked with both the other two.
Nuggets and Hockey.
I know, it's like, oh yeah, the poor Abilene.
But our guys are good.
Integer, biggest ad agency in Denver.
About 300 people.
We do a lot of work with them.
We do summer internships too, guys.
So you can get a 40-hour job week.
Integer hires 12 students.
Every summer.
Pays them.
It is a four-hour a week job.
So that looks great in your resume.
Oh, I worked at Integer.
Well, every ad agency in the U.S. knows Integer and Crispin Point.
Okay. So that's just some of the logos.
Okay, any questions?
Any questions about who we work with, how I work with you guys?
It's pretty simple.
Make a quick appointment with me.
We fill out some paperwork.
You go, hey, I got an internship made.
Awesome.
Fill out the paperwork, let's get you credit for spring or fall or winter or whatever it is.
And then we're off to the races.
And then you got to pay.
Usually a paid internship.
Four hours credit.
It's elective.
Marketing, $34.50.
So it's a marketing elective.
And you can take up to 10 hours of internship.
Okay, so that can be three internships, right?
Thank you. Cool. We also have some student groups, professional associations that help kind of support your
learnings around
marketing. We have DUMA,
the AMA, the American Marketing Association, the Business Marketing Association,
these are all that we can give you
more information about these.
These are great ways to kind of stay up to date.
So what we teach you and then what your bosses are going to be worried about, not always exactly the same thing, but as close as we can.
So it's interesting. And obviously those run events, right? So we have the American Marketing Association meetings,
which happen with frequency.
The DU Marketing Association, DUMA Lunch Speaker Series. Bring someone in, someone brilliant from a local company.
Grill them, ask them lots of questions.
Usually free lunch.
That's right.
It's not bad.
Voices of Experience Speaker Series is always good.
Hear from people that have been doing it for a while.
And been abused, as we kind of joked about before we started.
Career services events and backpacks to briefcases.
So these are all different organizations and associations that you can join to stay plugged in. Everybody can get their needs met through one of those organizations, for sure. Let me say just one thing about the career services events.
We have career fairs here that you guys are probably familiar with. We just had one at Driscoll. Not Driscoll. Richie.
The gym.
146 companies were there. Including probably every one of those logos. So I always tell my students, guys, you got to go to that, have a business card, make up a business card, have your resume with you. So one of my students got a job at Steamboat.
Her dream job. I was walking around giving my card out, and Annabelle comes up to me.
Oh my God, that's my dream job over there. So I'll go talk to him for you.
She goes, yeah, I've already talked to him.
So I went up, hey, have you met Annabelle? Annabelle's really sharp. I go, hey, that woman is awesome. I mean, she's taking two of my classes, I know her very well. Next day, Annabelle walks in saying, I got the job.
So she's going to be an intern for spring at Steamboat here in Denver.
And then come fall, summer, when she graduates, she goes full time with Steamboat.
And she said, I'm doing the circuit.
You're going to send me to Vail, to Brack.
I think it was a hotel chain of some sort.
That's cool.
She was so excited.
Awesome.
So those guys, about four huge. Bob had one just recently, in Daniels.
That was a good one.
All our partners were there. We have corporate partners. They were all there, and those are people that really want to hire you guys because they're really tied in with us, donate money to us. Like Enterprise Runner Car, who is one of our great corporate partners.
So if you have information about the marketing major, these are people to talk to, Stephen Hartley. That's his email address. Michelle Cunningham. Michelle Lutz.
Greg Wagner.
This gentleman over here. That's his email address.
If you want to contact me, text me, get about 250 emails a day
that I need to respond to. It just kind of gets lost.
So if you have any questions specific to digital,
go ahead and text me. If you call me, it's weird. I don't know what it means.
If you text me, it's much easier.
Undergraduate advising, advising, and Marjorie Reed.
And the marketing department is on the fourth floor of DCB.
And so come and ask us questions.
A lot of professors are in their office every day.
And just strike up a conversation and ask questions.
Yeah, I'm on the second floor, right out in the hallway.
He's not happy about it.
No win. Still don't have a win. 10 years.
So if you bring Greg a window, he'll get you an internship.
Doesn't have to have anything on the other side.
It just has to be a win.
So we wanted to finish up with just kind of putting up some questions specific to marketing, digital marketing, what it's really like, degree, and some of those things.
Anything? Yes, sir.
What about the difference between marketing and advertising? It's a good thing. It's a great question. Everybody thinks marketing is advertising.
Advertising is a subset of marketing. It's part of its promotion.
So marketing, if you actually look at the definition, it looks like the world's run-on sentence.
You're responsible for profit, which means revenue and costs, all sorts of operational things from a marketing standpoint. So it's pretty crazy. I know that's why a lot of people are not really into advertising. It's like,
you kidding me? There's like 15 other silos besides
advertising.
Advertising is fun,
exciting, and exciting.
It's a total challenge to get somebody to respond to something, engage with something.
I'll give you an example. When I was in business, we had a lot of MBAs.
And they were our account people usually. And the reason we wanted MBAs was because on the client side, those guys were all MBAs. Procter & Gamble, Crest 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 & G work with an MBA kind of thing.
Now, I don't think it's that true today.
I don't think the MBA is like, oh, I got to have my MS.
I don't think it's quite as crucial as it was back in the day.
Do you know if it is the other way? They want the MBA?
So, sort of go back to your question, advertising subset, marketing activities basically every business operating. So you could make a valid argument, single most important function in any business is marketing. Finance guys have nothing to do with that product or service. Brand is responsibility for the overall profit and loss. So it's a comprehensive, one-level way of managing business. Every major tech business, if you're looking at five, any sort of major technology or current company, not accounting, marketing is driving that. Not finance, not accounting, marketing, marketing. So advertising is a relatively small percentage, probably roughly 20% of actual career paths and jobs, but it's the most visible, and in that way the most important. Does that make sense? Yeah, you'll be working with the ad agency if you're on the client side.
We had a guy, Bill Weintraub, of course. He started his career at P&G. He was always on the brand side.
But I asked him in my class, Bill, how much time did you spend with the ad agency back in the day?
He said, almost every day.
I was either on the phone with them, or I was going to see a media presentation, or I was going to focus groups.
I had to approve the new campaign.
I'd go on the shoot, et cetera.
But he said he was dealing with the agency.
A lot.
I mean, sure, he had to deal with his own people, product, sales force, in store, all that stuff too.
But he said, you know, you got to deal with the agency. You have to have good taste in what's good advertising and bad advertising.
Because you're the one I'm showing it to.
And you're the one going yay or nay.
Okay.
So you have a huge responsibility.
So if I can just kind of go back to some of the things we talked about. In terms of internship, no matter whether you're in a marketing or accounting or whatever, you are at the end of your undergraduate program, you come out freshly plumbed diploma. You are not credible without an internship history. Unless your dad is in the business, right? So three most important people in college careers are in this room right now.
Specific to marketing, right?
It's great to help you get hooked up with internships. Mike can help you get an understanding of what's current and what's necessary to go out and get a job.
Just Tony can help you get a position, get ready for it.
So you know, okay. And then if you do a grad program, come.
The one thing I should mention now, for undergrad, Tony's got a whole department of people to help you, just the way Bob helps, Tony can help with undergrads.
So often Tony will send somebody to me that she saw an interest in a certain area. Saying, Greg, this dude is really excited about advertising.
And I send them to you, and I'm sure, I'll talk.
And so we all try to network together.
I mean, that's what makes our thing work.
Is that I work with Bob a lot, and Tony.
Michael is digital guru.
And since digital is so vital today,
You gotta know.
You gotta know it.
Scott, when he did his lecture to us the other day,
he said he started coding.
He was a coder.
I don't even know what a coder is, but it sounds pretty high tech to me.
And he said when he went to Crispin Porter,
he said there were just four of us.
We're the geek squad, we're the digital geeks.
Those days are over.
Everybody who comes in now has to have some really good grasp of digital.
So mobile apps, digital.
I was so many students take Michael's classes.
Because you got to know this.
I don't know it, but I don't have to.
I'd say the one skill set that you'll find out that people expect.
You're using the MBA to MBA.
Now I'm somewhat technical, and I'm also somewhat technical.
Right, and I really don't care what major you go into.
You need to be technical on some level.
It's a matter of literacy at this point.
If you don't understand how it works, you are less literate than someone coming in.
Has the same intelligence level you do, skill set, etc.
Except they've got that one extra nugget of, I know how these softwares work.
See it all the time.
Have a chance to hire biped A and biped B, and biped B has a little bit more technical expertise.
Pulling that person in.
Easy.
Why would I not?
I may never use it.
At least it's there.
Okay? Yes.
You know what, I wouldn't say a background programming.
I see a lot of people that want to do a marketing major and a computer science minor.
But I just have access to those skills.
And a lot of people get freaked out when they talk about code.
Like in my class, I'll show a picture of a shark and show a picture of code.
Which one they're more afraid of.
And most are more afraid of
code,
quite honestly.
But the fact is, we kind of do that class tech and marketing specifically. We kind of walk them off the ledge.
Get them to understand that it's pretty simple. There's just rules that you memorize. That's how it works. It's not like dynamically changes right in front of you.
If you make a mistake, it'll dynamically change in front of you.
But for the most part, they're a pretty good set of rules.
I mean, honestly, no matter what your major, if it's finance,
you're going to need to be technical.
There's a company called FinTech companies.
Where finance people are being replaced by software.
So you're either going to be part of that problem or be a recipient of that.
I can go down the list as far as all silos.
You need to be technical.
Period.
And do you need to be a total ninja at it?
No.
But you better be able to hold your own in a conversation.
Because
if you can't,
things get off the rails pretty quickly.
What else?
Yes.
So one of the letters for the movie business, what would a major get you into that kind of industry? Like what kind of job?
Well, what they do, National City Media, they own Regal, they own AMC. I mean, they're huge, they own all these theaters.
And when it comes to marketing, the job is how do we fill the theater on a dead Sunday morning?
Hey, let's have mass or a service there.
So the marketers are always looking for ways to fill the theater.
To have a concert.
It's the Rolling Stones at Wembley Live.
For 20 bucks, you can get into the movie theater and see it.
It's happening. So NCM, they work a lot like an ad agency.
They have a media department, they have a sales force.
You know the commercials that are on the big screen?
Somebody's got to go out and sell those.
Somebody's going to Coca-Cola saying, You should be on the big screen, guys.
So they have a sales force, they have a creative department.
First Look, are you guys familiar with First Look when you go to the theater?
That's NCM.
Fathom is one of their creative arms.
Fathom does First Look.
So they figure that out.
They go out and go to the TV shows and say,
we'll give you a five minute segment on First Look.
While people are just sitting around eating their popcorn and waiting for them.
You can talk about your new movie.
You can talk about your new TV show.
So it's pretty neat.
NCM, we've had great luck with them. Not only with interns, but going to full-time jobs.
Bob and I just posted two real jobs from a DU student,
Nellie Sanchez, who we helped get an interview there.
Nellie's been there three years.
And she comes back to me and says, Greg, I got two real jobs.
So I sent them to Bob.
You know, they're nice jobs.
And she said, you know, it's not bad starting, and they're very
cool
company.
We have a New York office.
We have a Chicago office. You know, where
and she's
looking at a new job in New York. And she said,
"By the way,
I'm hoping my job's going to be available
pretty soon.
Pretty soon, because I'm
pitching myself for the New York office."
So.
In regards to your question, so for search, mobile, social, and data science would play into all as far as getting people into theaters, specific to you. So I mean it's
pretty tight. It's pretty tight.
The joke that I always say is nobody sees you in front of the TV and waits for
information that they're curious about,
and they get online,
figure it out through their friends or through Google.
So we're definitely a part of that. What else?
Yeah, we'll help you guys market yourself.
Encourage you to build your own website.
That's really important now.
Because a lot of employers,
if they can't fly you in, send me your LinkedIn, not just LinkedIn, of course, y'all should be on, but send me your portfolio.
So. Think about building a portfolio over time while you're here.
And I'm sure Michael can help you with that.
We cover personal brands and social media. So currently what's happening is, specifically if you plan on staying in Colorado,
you're competing with people from Cornell and Yale.
The word is out on this place.
Everybody wants to live here.
So the fact is you have increased competition, so you have to do a better job with your portfolio,
with your ability to be found.
So it's not a website, it's also they want to look at your Instagram account, kind of know who you are as a human being.
People like to hire human beings, not hire robots.
If they want to hire robots, you don't want that job, I promise. Right?
So
we can help you through that process.
And it does.
And I know a lot of you are like, this is important to me now.
Trust me.
It'll be so important, so fast. You have no idea.
This young lady's a freshman. She already has an internship.
Categorically, you're already behind.
So start to think real aggressively.
Because those are the people that get the jobs.
They really want, and I ended up here.
Right?
And I can't, it saddens me every time I hear that.
I ended up here.
Not great.
So start now.
Building a network out.
By the way,
people talk to you all the time
if you're a student.
The second you graduate, you're somebody that needs a job.
Or like radioactive material.
You couldn't buy them.
There's no way. But the fact that you're a student and say, I want to grab coffee, tell me what's interesting about your field, area, or job, or whatever.
And really mean it.
You'll have the best coffee you've ever had.
Next time there's an internship opportunity,
they will come and talk to you first.
Okay,
this is how it works.
Specifically here.
It works everywhere else. But
you've got to start building that now.
Right. Yes.
Well, my experience, a lot of times it was a marketing minor.
A lot of times they're pretty fascinated about what that major.
So if it's psychology, they're like, it's a good combination, right?
Because then consumer behavior, it's to be second nature. It's like, I can tell you exactly why they're doing what they're doing.
Or finance and marketing.
Maybe you want to double market or have a major in business school and a minor in business school too.
That's not a bad way to go.
But to go arts, like I was a psych major and a marketing minor.
Led me into advertising. That was kind of how it happened for me.
When I graduated from St. Louis U.
I had to go to journalism school because I wanted to be a creative.
Ad or newspaper writer.
I wasn't sure which way.
Sports Illustrated or ad agency.
One of the two.
I wanted.
So it led me to go to J school because I figured I'm not prepared enough.
And now I really think I need that journalism. Background.
I knew Mizzou was in J school.
What's in demand?
Well, I think what you were talking about, I think if you're marketing with AA or computer science, I think that's really makes off right now. That's the big
Yeah, I mean, it's again, it's very technical.
And here's the deal, too.
If you don't
get a minor, but you want to be somewhat technical,
a lot of times,
if you say you're technical, they'll give you some sort of technical task to perform.
Like say,
send this to me tomorrow.
I want to see what your solution is.
It's HTML, CSS, or whatever it is, Photoshop, Illustrator.
The fact that you can prove it,
they're more interested in that.
Now, you do have the hurdle of saying, I've seen the focus on it,
but I'm good at it.
I've had lots of students that haven't taken any classes in
HTML, CSS, but they're really good at it because they just get on the side.
Tableau is something we have in science and marketing.
The other thing I'd say is we have tons of dependent studies.
So if you can't find a class that you're interested in,
my standard is sitting in the red chair in my office,
and I say,
what are two things you're passionate about?
And we cross-section those things,
and then you come up with some sort of strategy
about what you want to learn from that.
And then you leave kind of customized class.
I've had students aim that specifically at that job, but I need to show that I have those skills.
And no project triangulated in such a way that does that.
We're totally open for that.
It's your education.
I had an independent study student that wanted to work for Coca-Cola.
So I said, let's do a project for Coca-Cola.
I've got a student now, she's at Vail.
Doing an independent study with Lululemon.
She works for Lululemon.
And she said, I really want to work for these guys. When I get out, let's do a really cool project that you can present to your boss at Lululemon.
It's innovative, it's like, oh, I had this big idea, and let's do a PowerPoint on it, let's show them from start to finish how this works, and how it's going to make a new profit for Lululemon.
So she's all excited.
So we talk once a week.
That's my goal for the digital class. You're walking for a job, you've got a project in your hand.
For that company.
So instead of like, spend an hour on the website, kind of know what's going on.
It's like, here's a project, here's a strategy, and here's our investment, all those things.
And they kind of go, oh.
And all of a sudden the conversation switches from,
have you reviewed our website, do you understand what we do, to, wow, I'll bring you on.
Forward thinking,
and this is something
what have been thinking about, no idea of, but at least it's a better conversation than what your weakest entry, whatever.
Right, it's been a year since I've had that. Yes, sir.
Just to kind of close the conversation on minors. Most of the time, when I talk to employers who are hiring, minors not a thing. Employers don't care. What they do care about is specific relevant coursework. You can say. So, like what Tony was saying, here's a data visualization class, or mobile app class that I took, kind of the notion of saying, psych major with a marketing minor, nothing.
Great. What else?
We hope to see you guys in class.
That's right.
Cool.
Thank you.